wa Shangwe na Nderemo tunapoleta our sub-region, our officer, our father, Reverend David, anapokuja. Let's appreciate him in a powerful way. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen, amen. Karibu. Welcome, sir.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord.
Bwana litukuzwe.
I want to see people who are happy today.
Nataka kuona watu ambao wamefurahia leo.
In the presence of the Lord.
Uwepo wake Mwenyezi Mungu.
Amen.
Amina.
So thank you once again.
Asante mara tena.
And welcome in our very powerful service.
Karibu kwa ibada yetu ya nguvu.
Without forgetting our people.
Bila kusahau.
And our faithful followers.
Wale watu ambao wanatufuata.
Of number one TV.
Kwa television ya number one.
We also welcome you.
Tunawakaribisha.
Now we pray for the blessing of God.
Tunaombea baraka za Mwenyezi Mungu.
Upon your life.
Kwa maisha yenu.
In Jesus name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
God bless you.
Wacha Mungu akubariki.
Let's be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Tunaketi kwa uwepo wa Mwenyezi Mungu.
Amen.
Amina.
We thank God.
Nashukuru Mungu.
Despite many things that are happening today.
Bali na vitu ambavyo vinatendeka leo.
God has helped us.
Mungu ametusaidia.
The grace of the Lord has been sufficient.
Neema ya Mungu imekuwa ya kutosha.
In all our lives and all circumstances.
Kwa maisha yetu na hali zote.
The Lord has prevailed.
Mungu ameonekana.
Amen.
Amina.
I want us to read the scripture.
Nataka tusome andiko.
From the book of 2 Corinthians.
Kutoka kitabu cha Wakorintho wa pili.
Chapter 8.
Mlango ni wa 8
verse 1 to 14.
Mstari wa kwanza hadi wa 14.
We are only reading that portion.
Tunasoma tu sehemu hiyo.
Because I'm using it to give an explanation of some of the things.
Kwa sababu ndatumia kupeana ufafanuzi wa baadhi ya vitu.
But God expects us to know such a time.
Ambavyo Mungu anatumainia sisi tujue wakati huu.
Amen.
Amina.
We want you to know, brothers, about the grace of God. Has been given among the churches of Macedonia.
Tena ndugu zetu, tuwaarifu habari ya neema ya Mungu waliopewa makanisa ya Makedonia.
For in severe test of affliction, the abundance of joy and the extreme poverty have overflowed in a wealth of generosity on their part.
Maana walipokuwa wakijaribiwa kwa dhiki nyingi, wingi wa furaha yao na umaskini wao ulikuwa mwingi ulioongeza utajiri wa ukarimu wao.
For they gave according to their means, as I can testify, and beyond their means of their own accord.
Maana nawashuhudia kwamba kwa uweza wao na zaidi ya uweza wao, kwa hiari yao wenyewe walitoa vitu vyao.
Begging us earnestly for the favor of taking part in the relief of the saints.
Wakituomba sana pamoja na kutusihi kwa habari ya neema hii na shirika hili la kuwahudumia watakatifu.
And this not as you expected, but they gave themselves first to the Lord and then by the will of God to us.
Tena walitenda hivi si kwa tulivyotumaini tu, bali kwanza walijitoa nafsi zao kwa Bwana na kwetu pia kwa mapenzi ya Mungu.
Accordingly, we urge Titus that as he has started, so he should continue among you this act of grace.
Hata tukamwonya Tito kuatimizia neema hii kwenu kama vile yeye alivyotangulia kuianzisha.
But as you excel in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in earnestness, and our love for you, see that you excel in this act of grace also.
Lakini kama mlivyo na wingi wa mambo yote, imani na usemi na elimu na bidii yote na upendo wenu kwetu sisi, basi vivyo hivyo mpate wingi wa neema hii pia.
I say this not as a command, but to prove by the earnestness of others that your love is also genuine.
Sineni ili kuamuru, bali kwa bidii ya watu wengine nijaribu unyofu wa upendo wenu.
For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that you may by his poverty might become rich.
Maana mmejua neema ya Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo, jinsi alivyokuwa maskini kwa ajili yenu, ingawa alikuwa tajiri, ili kwamba ninyi mpate kuwa matajiri kwa umaskini wake.
And this matter I give my judgment, this benefits you who a year ago started not only to do this work but also desire to do it.
Nami katika neno hili natoa shauri langu, maana neno hili la wafaa ninyi mliotangulia yapata mwaka. Licha ya kutenda haya, na kutaka pia.
So now finish doing it as well, so that your readiness in serving it may be matched by your completing it out of what you have.
Lakini sasa timizeni kule kutenda nako, ili kama vile mlivyokuwa tajiri kutaka, vivyo hivyo mkawe tajiri na kutimiza kwa kadri ya mlivyo navyo.
For if the readiness is there, it is acceptable according to what a person has, not according to what he does not have.
Maana kama nia ipo, hukubaliwa kwa kadri ya alivyo navyo mtu, si kwa kadri ya asivyo navyo.
For I do not mean that others should be eased and you be burdened, but that as a matter of fairness.
Maana sisemi hayo, ili wengine wapate raha, nanyi mpate dhiki.
Your abundance at the present time should supply the need, so that the abundance may supply your need, that may be fairness.
Bali mambo yawe sawa sawa wakati huu wa sasa, wingi wenu uwafae upungufu wao, ili na wingi wao uwafae ninyi mtakapo pungukiwa, ili mambo yawe sawa sawa.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
So we discover from the scriptures we are reading.
Tunagundua kutoka kwa andiko ambalo tumesoma.
Apostle Paul.
Huyu mtume Paulo.
When you read this portion of scripture.
Wakati unasoma sehemu hii ya maandiko.
You discover he's talking about a number of churches.
Unagundua kuwa anazungumza kuhusu makanisa.
And the first church is talking about.
Kanisa la kwanza ambalo anazungumzia.
Is talking about the churches.
Anazungumzia makanisa.
It was not one church.
Hailikuwa kanisa moja.
He was talking about the Macedonian churches.
Alikuwa anazungumzia kuhusu makanisa ya Makedonia.
So that is why in verse 1.
Ndio maana kwa mstari wa kwanza.
He's talking about the grace.
Anazungumzia kuhusu neema.
That was upon the Macedonian churches.
Ambayo ilikuwa kwa kanisa la Makedonia.
And for the people who are reading.
Kwa wale ambao walikuwa wanasoma.
Especially the book of Acts of Apostles.
Wale ambao walikuwa wanasoma kitabu cha Matendo ya Mitume.
You discover there is a person, there is a time.
Tunagundua kuwa kuna wakati.
When God then Apostle Paul.
Ambao mtume Paulo.
In his vision.
Kwa maono yake.
A man.
Aliona mtu.
A man of Macedonia.
Mtu wa Makedonia.
And was standing and telling him.
Alikuwa anasimama na anamwambia.
In a vision.
Kwa maono.
Come over.
Kuja.
To Macedonia.
Huko Makedonia.
And help us.
Na utusaidie.
So this man.
Huyo mtu.
He began his ministry.
Alianza tume yake.
His mission.
Utume yake.
In Macedonia.
Kule Makedonia.
And I know Macedonia.
Na kule Makedonia.
Is Europe.
Ni ukule Europa.
There was the first time.
Ilikuwa mara ya kwanza.
But this a man was a preaching.
Huyo mtu alikuwa anahubiri.
To the European nations.
Kwa wale mataifa ya Europa.
So he had a voice.
Alikuwa na sauti.
A man saying.
Mtu alisema.
Come over.
Njoo.
To Macedonia.
Huko Makedonia.
And help us.
Na utusaidie.
So he went there.
Alienda huko.
He did his work.
Alifanya kazi yake.
You discover that when he talk of Macedonian churches.
Tunagundua tunapozungumzia makanisa ya Makedonia.
In short we are talking about the church of Philippi.
Kwa ufupi tunazungumzia makanisa ya Filipi.
There were three churches there.
Kulikuwa na makanisa matatu pale.
We were talking of churches in Macedonia.
Tunapozungumzia makanisa ya Makedonia.
He was talking of the church of Philippi.
Alikuwa anazungumzia kanisa la Filipi.
The church of Thessalonica.
Kanisa la Thessalonike.
And the church of Berea.
Na kanisa la Berea.
Philippi.
Filipi.
And Thessalonica.
Thessalonica.
And Berea.
Na Berea.
These were the churches.
Haya ndio alikuwa makanisa.
But this man of God began.
Ambaye huyu mtu wa Mungu alianzisha.
When he heard the man.
Wakati alisikia huyu.
Telling him come over.
Akimwambia njoo.
And help us.
Na utusaidie.
He went there and began and did a good work.
Alienda pale na akaanza kazi na kufanya kazi
iliyokuwa. I know he suffered a lot.
Aliuteswa.
When he was that time.
Wakati alikokuwa.
When I remember he was a Philippi.
Alikuwa hapo wakati alikuwa Philippi.
He encountered a lot of challenges.
Alipitia changamoto nyingi.
But he was able to establish churches.
Lakini alikuwa na uwezo kuanzisha makanisa
in that place.
Oh, pali pali.
So when you continue again,
wakati napoendelea,
in the same verse,
kwa ile mstari mwingine,
is telling us,
inatuambia,
he was writing to the Corinthian church,
alikuwa anazungumzia ile kanisa la Korintho,
but he was giving what was happening in the churches of Macedonia,
yale ambayo alikuwa anatendeka kwa kanisa la Makedonia,
he was giving description,
alikuwa anawapea ufafanuzi,
of the churches of Macedonia,
ya kanisa la Makedonia,
and this were the churches,
na haya ndio alikuwa makanisa,
they were young churches,
yalikuwa makanisa changa.
They were not churches that had stayed for a long time.
Hayakuwa makanisa ambayo yalikuwa yamekaa muda mrefu.
They were young churches.
Yalikuwa makanisa ambayo yalikuwa changa.
Also,
pia
these were were the churches
haya makanisa
that they were persecuted
yalikuwa yakiteswa
from time to time
wakati hadi wakati
because of their faith
kwa sababu ya imani yao
so they were not in comfort zone
hayakuwa yanafurahia
they were suffering
yalikuwa yanateswa
they were persecuted
yalikuwa yanateswa
because of their faith
kwa sababu ya imani yao
so this is the church
haya ndio makanisa
churches under persecution
makanisa ambayo yalikuwa yanateswa
from time to time
kwa wakati hadi wakati
suffering
yalikuwa yanaumia
was part of life
ilikuwa kawaida ya maisha
the members in this church
wale watu katika yale makanisa
when encountering a lot of suffering
walikuwa wanapatia changamoto
so many challenges
makanisa yalikuwa na
because of their faith
kwa sababu ya imani yao
also in this church
pia haya makanisa
we are told they were poor
tunaambia kuwa
the churches were poor
yalikuwa maskini
when we talk of poverty
tunapoongea kuhusu maskini
I know that when we talk of the church
tunapozungumzia kanisa
we are not talking of the building
hatuongea tu juu ya makanisa
we are talking about the members
tunazungumza kuhusu wale ambao kwenye kanisa
so the members
wale ambao walikuwa kwenye makanisa
in the churches of Macedonia
kanisa la Makedonia
these were very poor
walikuwa maskini
they had inadequate resources
hawakuwa na rasilimali za kutosha
they could not fulfill some of their needs
hawakuwa naweza kutosheleza mahitaji yao
they were very poor people
walikuwa maskini
also in this church
pia katika makanisa
they had excelled in one thing
walikuwa wamepita kwa kitu kimoja
as we can see there were challenges
kulikuwa na changamoto ndio
but one of the things
lakini kitu ambacho
the churches excelled
ambacho kanisa ilikuwa inafanya
bora excelled in the grace
ilikuwa na neema
in the grace of giving
inafanya vizuri kwa neema
despite all these things
kando na hizo changamoto
Paul talks about excelling
anaongea kuhusu
in the grace of giving
kwa neema ya kutoa
they were poor
walikuwa maskini
persecuted
walikuwa wanateswa
there were people who are young
walikuwa
salvation
ambao ni wachanga kwa wokovu
but one thing that comes out
kitu moja ambacho inajitokeza
it was the grace
ilikuwa neema
the grace of giving
neema ya kutoa
so back to the church of Corinth
kwa kanisa la Wakorintho
now when you come to the church of Corinth
unapokuja kanisa la Wakorintho
when you read verse 7
tunaposoma mstari wa 7
verse 7
mstari wa 7
apostle says but as you excel in everything
anasema kuwa lakini kama mlivyo na wingi wa mambo yote
you excel in faith
mnaizidisha kwa imani
in speech
na usemi
in knowledge
na elimu
in earnestness
na bidii yote
and in your love
na upendo
see that you excel
hivyo vivyo
also in this grace
mpate wingi wa neema hii
so be church of Corinth
ni kanisa la Wakorintho
the church of Corinth
kanisa la Wakorintho
they had excelled
walikuwa wamefaulu
in faith
kwa imani
they were people full of faith
walikuwa na watu ambao walikuwa wamejaa imani
they people who can trust
walikuwa watu ambao walikuwa
wanaamini they can speak of faith
walikuwa wananena kuhusu
imani they were confident
walikuwa na ujasiri
in whatever they did
kwa kila kitu ambacho walifanya
they were not afraid of anything
hawakuwa naogopa chochote
they were people of faith
walikuwa watu wa imani
also this church
pia hili kanisa
the church of Corinth
hili kanisa la Wakorintho
it also excelled
walikuwa pia wamefaulu
in knowledge
kwa maarifa
they were people who had knowledge
walikuwa watu ambao walikuwa na maarifa
knowledge was part of them
maarifa ilikuwa sehemu yao
people full of knowledge
watu ambao walikuwa wamejazwa na maarifa
praise the name of the Lord
Bwana litukuzwe
also in this church
pia kwenye hili kanisa
people were excelling
watu walikuwa wamefaulu
in speech
kwa uneni
they are people full of speech
walikuwa watu ambao walikuwa wanaweza kunena
if anyone could stand
kama mtu angesimama
he could give a speech
alikuwa anatoa uneni
public speakers
ingekuwa wale watu walitoa uneni ulio bora walikuwa wananena vizuri
also in the church
pia kwenye hili kanisa
in the church of Corinth
kanisa la Wakorintho
people were hard working
watu walikuwa wabidii
amen
amen
but one thing
kitu kimoja
but apostle prays for them
ambacho mtume alikuwa anasema
he says as you excel in faith
anasema mnapozidika kwa imani
as you excel in knowledge
pia mnazidika kwa
as you excel in hard work
mnazidika kwa
as you excel in speech
pia mnazidika kwa uneni
he prayed for them
aliwaombea
but may you excel also
kufaulu
in the grace of giving
kwa neema ya kutoa
praise the Lord
jina la Bwana
may you excel in the grace of giving
kwa neema ya kutoa
you are full of speech
ninyi mnaweza kunena
you are full of knowledge you are full of everything the faith you have the knowledge you have the speech you have the hard work you have but there is one thing that is lacking there is a grace of giving praise the name of the Lord so I'm still sharing on how to experience divine
English
divine English so today I think is point number 6
ni kipengele cha sita
I don't want to mention others because I know I have taken time
kwa sababu najua nimechukua muda
to share on this
kushiriki hayo
so today
leo
to increase to experience divine increase, we need to practice what we call biblical giving. Biblical giving. It is not giving out of manipulation. It's not giving out of force. It is a biblical one. We are using the church. The church of Macedonia. They were practical. They are having problems. They are having persecution. They are facing challenges. But one thing they said, this is a church. They can talk about it because they had a grace. The grace of giving was upon their lives. In that church, we had the grace. The grace of giving was on that church. Poor as they were, they were having problems. They were having challenges. But one thing that comes strongly, the church excels in the grace of giving. I pray in Jesus' name. May God help us. Give us a grace. The grace of giving. Whenever the grace of giving comes upon the church, comes upon individuals, they will start to grow. They will start to increase. You cannot increase economically our resources. We cannot be blessed. We experience a multitude of blessings. Praise the name of the Lord. We are talking of blessing. We are talking of blessing. And last time I was sharing, when we talk of blessing, we are not talking of money. We are talking of so many things. Blessings is good health. Blessing is forgiveness of sins. Praise the name of the Lord. To experience those things, there are many people today who have resources, who have money, but the problems are there. They have no marriage. They are suffering. No marriage. No children. Sickness is all over. Confusion and a problem. Because there are no blessings. Praise the name of the Lord. So for us to increase divine increase, we must receive the grace. The more grace, the more grace comes, the more you increase. The blessing will increase. The blessing will multiply. Depending on the grace. The more grace of giving upon you, upon your family will start taking a different direction, a different way. A blessing will be upon you, will be upon everything you do because of the grace. May you receive the grace of giving in Jesus' name. May the grace of giving come upon our life. In Jesus' name, the grace of giving will open doors for you. The grace of giving will give you grace. The grace of giving will rebuke destroyers in your life. Destroyers are destroyed by the power, the grace of giving. There are some calamities, there are some hardships, there are some things you can unlock them out whenever there is a grace of giving. Every family and every individual that has the grace of giving, the devourers, destroyers, diseases, premature death, and some of the problems are rebuked, not even with prayer, but because of the grace. The more grace you receive, the more you increase in every dimension. You increase to the west, increase to the west, to the east, to the north, to the south, in all dimensions, because you understand biblical giving. Praise the name of the Lord. People have never known the secret. People have prayed. When you called everywhere, people are praying. They have visited prayer mountain. They are praying for the blessing. And some of the things, biblical giving. Praise the name of the Lord. So using this scripture,
kutumia haya maandishi,
I'll be sharing a few things.
Nitakuwa na shiriki baadhi ya vitu.
Amen.
Amina.
Of what we can learn from this church.
Vitu ambavyo tunaweza soma kutoka kwenye
this church.
Hii ni kanisa.
A poor church.
Hii ni kanisa maskini.
But we can learn.
Ambalo vitu ambavyo tunaweza soma.
What biblical giving.
Ni kutoa kwa kibiblia.
According to the scripture here.
Kulingana na
andiko. We are only getting from here.
Tunasoma kutoka
kwa andiko. We know we can use different books.
Tunaweza tumia vitabu tofauti.
When you move to 2 Corinthians. Chapter 9. We have some others. But I want to limit myself.
Nataka kujikita.
Sharing around four things. Of this biblical giving.
Ambavyo vinahusisha
kwa kiungu. But I'm talking about.
Ambavyo nazungumzia.
I have observed.
Nimeangalia.
With my own eyes.
Kwa macho yangu.
I have a witness of this.
Nimeona mimi ni mshahidi.
We can bear witness.
Tunaweza toa ushahidi.
Because these things.
Kwa sababu hivi vitu.
Will produce wonders.
Vitaleta matokeo.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Bwana libariki.
But biblical giving.
Kuwa kutoa kwa kiungu.
This is a costly giving.
Hii ni ya gharama.
It must cost you.
Lazima utoe gharama.
In a biblical way.
Kutoa gharama kibiblia.
It must cost you.
Lazima utoe gharama.
You must plan for it.
Lazima upange.
In biblical giving.
Kwa kutoa kibiblia.
People plan for
it. Watu wanapangia.
It is a costly work.
Ni kazi ambayo ina gharama.
You cannot just wake up.
Hautaamka tu.
And do anything.
Na kusema na kufanya chochote.
You plan for it.
Lazima uipangie.
You plan for it.
Lazima uipangie.
It must cost you.
Lazima ikugharamishe.
It must cost some pain.
Lazima utoe uchungu.
It must cause some discomfort.
Lazima ikupe uchungu.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
It's not just a matter.
Si ma kitu.
If when somebody comes to church.
Unakuja tu kanisani.
Then he asks your neighbor.
Unauliza jirani.
Uko na 50?
Saidia 50.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amina.
And you have others in the pocket.
Na una noti zingine kwenye mfuko.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Nakumbuka siwe sahau nilikuwa kwa mkutano mahali. Mtu aliniomba pesa 150. Na hajawahi nirudishia mpaka wae. Unachua hii mambo ya kompyuta imeleta kitu inaitwa soft copy and hard copy.
Pesa zenye ziko kwa simu na zile.
Akaniuliza uko na hard copy 150.
Uko na taslimu, pesa taslimu.
Mimi nitakupatia soft copy. Up today I have not received the soft copy.
Sasa hajapokea ile pesa.
Praise the name of the Lord. Because these people,
kwa sababu hawa watu,
they don't attach the value.
Hawana thamani.
So according to him,
kulingana
when he checked in the pocket,
wakati aliangalia kwenye mfuko,
he saw 200.
Akaona noti ya 200.
So he saw this 200.
Akaona hii 200.
I must just con this man.
Lazima niambie mtu.
So you cannot con somebody.
Huwezi la
this one can never be accepted.
Haiwezi kubalika.
And many people con are con.
Watu wengi wanalagaiwa.
I've discovered in the church.
Nimegundua hapa kanisani.
Many people are con.
Watu wanalagaiwa.
Nisaidie 50.
Nisaidie.
Nakutumia kwa simu. They never send.
Hawatumi.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amina.
Part one is not costing you.
Hiyo haikugharimu.
It must come from you.
Lazima itoke
kwako. You cannot borrow your neighbor.
Hauwezi omba jirani.
In the church.
Katika kanisa.
You cannot borrow.
Hautaomba.
When you are coming from home.
Wakati unapotoka nyumbani.
You must have a plan.
Lazima uwe na mpango.
Praise the Lord.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
Somebody is coming.
Mtu anakuja kanisani.
With a husband.
Na mume wake.
He's coming with a wife.
Wanakuja na mke.
When he comes in the church.
Wanakuja kanisani.
Uko na 50.
Uko na 50.
When you come from home.
Wakati ulitoka nyumbani.
You must plan.
Lazima upange.
Something costly.
Kitu ambacho kitakuwa na
gharama. It must cost you.
Lazima ukue.
You feel some discomfort.
Usikuwe na.
That is what is expected. When you read the scripture.
Wakati nasoma andiko.
When you read the Bible.
Wakati naposoma Biblia.
People refuse.
Watu walikataa.
Some cheap things.
Vitu
they refused to offer to God.
Walikataa kupenda.
You see a man like David.
Mtu kama Daudi.
There is a day he said.
Kuna siku alisema.
When he was given.
Wakati alikuwa anapewa.
An offering.
Ile sadaka.
Free of charge.
Ambayo ilikuwa ya bure.
To offer to God.
Kupeana kwa Mungu.
He said.
Alisema.
I cannot offer.
Siwezi toa sadaka.
Something.
Kitu.
That does not cost me.
Ambacho sijatolea gharama.
People of God.
Watu wa Mungu.
You cannot offer.
Hauwezi toa.
Something.
Kitu.
But it cannot cost you.
Ambacho si cha gharama kwako.
It must cost you.
Lazima utole gharama.
You must feel pain.
Lazima uhisi uchungu.
Praise the Lord.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
Even when you are giving somebody something.
Hata wakati unapea mtu kitu.
If you are giving somebody something.
Unapea mtu kitu.
You must look for a new thing.
Lazima uangalie kitu ambacho ni kipya.
Praise the Lord.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
If it's not new.
Kama si kipya.
It's supposed to be in good condition.
Lazima kiwe kikobora kwa hali nzuri.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
You cannot look for a phone.
Usiangalie simu.
Which says battery low.
Inasema
every time
haina moto
battery low
kila wakati nasema haina moto
even after charging
hata unaweka kwenye moto
it is reading 100%
inasema iko asilimia
when you remove it from the charging
inasema
it says battery low
haina moto
then you think
na unafikiria
what can I do
naweza fanya nini
oh yes tomorrow is Sunday
Jumapili
Sunday tomorrow
kesho ni Jumapili
this phone
hii kitu
It must go to the basket.
Hey,
it must go to the basket. That one, it can never bring a blessing. Praise the name of the Lord. If you give a phone, you must decide. You must decide. But I'm giving a better phone. Praise the Lord. If you keep an animal, it must be in good condition. It must not be sick. Or lame. You cannot give a lame animal.
He's
serious. It is an offense in the eyes of God. You cannot take to the church a lame animal. It is unbiblical. It is unbiblical to give a blind animal. Praise the Lord. Even when you take to the market a blind animal with only one eye, if it is 40,000, you will sell it at 20. Because they know in the world today, or you take an animal on the market with no teeth, however expensive it is, you will sell at 20. 50, you will sell at 20. An animal with no teeth. So you cannot take to the church or offer to God an animal with no teeth. You take it to the show. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Where they, there's a place where they take their animals of one leg, of two legs, of one eye. You take it there for the tourists. Praise the name of the Lord. So that is what I'm saying. It must cost you. Praise the Lord. It must cost you. A biblical giving. It must cost you. My brother, my sister, it must cost you. It is not a leftover. It is not by the way. When the week begins, you must start planning. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Stop borrowing, offering. Stop borrowing. If you have been borrowing, I command in Jesus' name, you must stop borrowing. You must have yours. You have 1,000. You are borrowing 50. Come out of that. In Jesus' name. You cannot borrow 20. And you have more. Come out. Have yours. Besides, it must be costly. Praise the Lord. If you buy your brother, if you say I'm buying my brother something, you must sit down and plan. I'm going to bless this family. Praise the Lord. I am going to bless them. I am going to bless them with the shoes. Praise the Lord. I am blessing them with the shoes. You look for good shoes. Not your soul. That one, my brother, will never bring blessings. Look for something better. Something that can touch you. Amen. When it is going away, there's somebody who was saying, when you want to test, whatever you want to give out, you feel some pain. You need to feel some pain. If you are giving out something, you don't feel pain. That is not the kind one. You feel pain. If you give an offering, you must feel pain. Praise the Lord. I have seen people who give 1,000
notes.
I have seen with my eyes 1,000 notes. The other side is not there. Let's
suppose
it dancing.
Anapeana hapo noti nusu.
That one, my brother,
ndugu yangu,
it will never bless you. It had a curse on your life. I pray in Jesus' name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
May you get a revelation. Something must cost you. You must know.
Lazima ujue.
The biblical giving,
ile kutoka
kibili, it must cost you.
Lazima iwe ni ya gharama.
You first feel pain.
Unahisi uchungu.
Praise the Lord.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
That is biblical.
Hiyo ni ya kibiblia.
That is biblical.
Hiyo ni ya
kibiblia. And that is one will bring increase.
Kitu ambacho kitaleta
all other things
vitu vingine vyote
will never change your life.
Itabadilisha
maisha. You can do it for many years.
Unaweza kwa miaka mingi.
Your life will remain the same.
Maisha yako
itabaki. Your family will remain the same.
Jamii yako itabaki.
Your family will struggle. Many things in life.
Vingi kwa maisha.
I pray in Jesus name.
Naomba kwa jina la Yesu.
Have a revelation.
Wacha upate ufunuo.
Number 2.
Nambari ya pili.
Biblical giving.
Kutoa kwa kibiblia.
It grows from time to time.
Inakuwa kutoka muda hadi muda.
It grows from time to time. As a person
kama mtu
grows.
Unaendelea
giving
kuwa.
Also grows.
Pia kutoa kuna
giving
kuwa.
Is not stationary.
Hiyo kutoa haikai pale.
It is not fixed.
Haisema endelee kukaa pale.
It is not flat rate.
Haitaendelee kukaa pale.
Praise the Lord.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
Giving is not flat rate.
Kutoa haibaki pale.
Tell your neighbor.
Ambia jirani yako.
Giving is not flat rate.
Kutoa haibaki pale.
It must grow.
Lazima ikue.
Of time to time.
Muda kwa muda.
Everything grows.
Kila kitu lazima inakuwa.
Everything grows.
Kila kitu inakuwa.
Everything grows.
Kila kitu inakuwa.
It is not stationary.
Haisimami pale.
Amen.
Amina.
When I was young
wakati nilikuwa mchanga
with carrying maize
wakakibeba mahindi
I no longer carry maize
I baby mahindi tena
we used to carry one cup of maize
tulikuwa na beba moja
taking it there
tunapeleka kanisani
we used to carry limotole
tulikuwa na beba tongo
limotole is no longer there
tongolo haipo.
Praise the Lord. We used to carry mayai.
Tulikuwa na beba.
We are no longer carrying mayai.
Tena,
when somebody see you with an with an egg today.
Mayai leo.
I think he will call for Radio Citizen.
Ataisha.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
He will see that you are a surprise.
Ataona.
They will look at you and wonder.
Kushangaa.
Even Sunday school children.
Hata watoto la tele.
They can compose a song.
Wanatengeneza wimbo.
And dance around you.
Na kuanza kucheza.
What is happening?
Nini inatendeka?
Praise the name of the Lord. So that is what I'm saying.
Ndio sababu nasema.
Giving is not flat rate. Every year.
Kila mwaka.
It must grow.
Lazima ikue.
If there is a person who is practicing biblical giving,
kutoa kwa kibiblia.
A person who is doing that. It must grow.
Lazima ikue.
Praise the Lord. We cannot give the same.
Hatutaendelea kutoa sawa.
Sometimes in that month.
Wakati mwingine.
In that month. You may expect some sources.
Unaweza pata vitu.
Somebody greets you.
Mtu anakusalimia.
With 1000.
1000.
Another one give you 500.
Unakusalimia.
You are adding some things.
Unaongeza vitu.
Life cannot be constant.
Maisha haiwezi bakia pale.
It can never be constant.
Haiwezi bakia pale.
You are growing.
Unakuwa.
You are growing.
Unakuwa.
Every month.
Kila mwezi.
You are blessed differently.
Unabarikiwa tofauti.
In this 12th month. From January.
Kutoka January.
To December.
Hadi December.
The months are not the same.
Haiko sawa.
There is a month.
Kuna mwezi.
Where you will be surprised
ambao utashangazwa.
So that is what I'm saying.
Yeye anasema
biblical giving
kutoka kwa kibiblia.
It is not flat rate.
Haita pale.
It must grow.
Lazima ikue.
The way you used to give
wakati jinsi ulivyokuwa
in 1990
miaka ile ya
90 is not the same way
jinsi
the amount you give
ile kitu ambayo ulikuwa
in 1990
ile miaka ile
is not the same
jinsi
because our income grows.
Sababu kupeana kwetu kumekuwa.
Our income grows.
Hata mshahara wetu inakuwa.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Our income grows.
Mshahara wetu inakuwa.
Ama hiyo wakati ulikuwa umeanza maybe unafanya job ama unafanya business umeanza income yako ilikuwa kidogo today you are a landlord praise the Lord
amina
you are a landlord
wewe ni mwenye nyumba
have things have changed have they changed?
Unaona vitu vimebadilika.
You cannot be the same my brother.
Vimebadilika.
We can never be the same.
Hatuwezi kuwa sawia.
We can never.
Hatuwezi.
Biblical giving.
Kutoa kwa kibiblia.
It keeps on
growing. Inaendelea kukua.
As you grow, your resources grow.
Rasilimali zao zinakuwa.
Our giving grows. Depending on our resources.
Kulingana na rasilimali zetu.
I pray in Jesus name.
Naomba kwa jina la Yesu.
May God help us.
Acha Mungu atusaidie.
May our income grow.
Acha matoma.
May our income grow.
Acha matoma.
May our things grow.
Acha vitu vyetu
viongezeke. Whatever we are doing.
Kila kitu ambacho tunafanya.
I pray in Jesus name.
Naomba kwa jina la Yesu.
May you grow.
Acha ukue.
In Jesus name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Na Bwana litukuzwe.
So I'm saying.
Nasema.
We cannot be the same.
Hatuwezi kuwa sawia.
In January to December.
January hadi December.
We can never be the same.
Hatuwezi kuwa sawia.
Praise the Lord.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
Kuna wakati unaona mwezi fulani unashutuliwa. Unaona wamecombine umefikisha karibu 1300.
Umeweka pamoja.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
You have 300 that month. And you used to give 2,000. It can never be 2,000. My sister, it cannot be that. That one will be a lie.
We'll
be a lie to ourselves and to a lie to God. We can never be the same every month. Every year you cannot be the same. We cannot have a flood rate of 500 shillings. See 1984. 500. 1984. 1990, 1992, 2023, 500. That is a lie to ourselves and a lie to the Holy Spirit. I pray in Jesus' name, may we get a revelation that we be forgiving. It grows day by day, year by year, time by time. It must grow. If you are practicing the Bible, if really we are practicing the Bible, we cannot be like Corinthian church. Praise the Lord. Which were excellent in speech. They were excellent in knowledge. They were excellent in faith. But zero in the grace of giving. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Are you seeing that? So you can have faith, but it's useless without the grace of giving. You can have knowledge, but it's useless without the grace of giving. You can have knowledge. You can quote the scripture, but that one is useless without the grace. I pray in Jesus' name, may receive the grace in Jesus' name. Biblical giving, it grows from time to time. Are we together? I'm reading the scripture. So I'm preaching. Amen. I'm preaching. Where are you getting? Where are you getting these things? I am reading in 2 Corinthians chapter 8. So whatever I'm sharing, when you just read those verses, you discover those things are out. They are coming from those portions of scripture. Amen. So I said I will teach the Bible. I'm not teaching my own words. I'm not teaching my opinion. We are teaching the Bible. Biblical giving. It grows from time to time. Amen. Amen. So when you are promoted,
wakati unapandishwa
cheo, it is reflected.
Inaonekana.
It must be reflected.
Lazima ionekane.
Amen.
Amen.
How do you know?
Utajuaje?
You have been promoted.
Kuwa nimepandishwa cheo. Kwa kutoa.
Growing time to time.
Muda kwa mwingine.
It's not a testimony. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
There are people who give testimonies.
The
Lord has promoted me. Join me. Join me. Join me. In celebrating. In a cell group now. So it's in a cell group. Brethren. The Lord is faithful. Join me. In a joy. Or celebrating. The promotion of God. But now. It cannot. It is seen nowhere. There's nothing to see.
Hakuna cha kuona.
It is the same.
Ni vivyo tu imebakia vile.
500 shillings.
500.
It is the same.
500.
With joining me.
Na ume,
even with joining me.
Hata umetumesherekea.
In celebrating with me.
Umesherekea na mimi.
Join me.
Kuja.
In celebrating with me.
Kuja tusherekee.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Bwana tukuzwe.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amina.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Bwana litukuzwe.
Amen.
Amen.
I pray in Jesus' name.
Naomba kwa jina la Yesu.
It is also proportionate.
Pia inategemea, inawiana.
It is proportionate.
Inategemea.
Depending
kulingana
on you.
Na wewe.
Praise the Lord. It depends on your status.
Inategemea hali yako.
Your status.
Hali yako.
Your position.
Nafasi yako.
Determines your giving.
Inajalisha kutoa kwako.
Praise the Lord. Your status.
Hali yako.
As an individual.
Kama mtu binafsi.
It determines.
Inajalisha.
The way of giving.
Kutoa kwako.
We cannot give the same.
Hatuwezi toa sawa.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
That is why in some cases.
Ndio sababu tunasema kwa hali zingine.
I refuse.
Nakataa.
When we were somewhere.
Wakati tulikuwa mahali.
And then they are saying.
Wanasema.
We are keeping this group 5,000.
Kikundi.
This group 5,000.
Hiyo kikundi 5,000. Hiki kikundi 5,000.
And then they say, let us divide.
Na wanasema tugawi.
Mia, 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 mia. I say no.
Mia, mia.
That one can never happen.
Yeah, yes, it endeka.
That is not proportionate.
Iyo,
praise the Lord.
Amina.
My conscience cannot allow. My conscience cannot allow. Praise the name of the Lord. Because when I look at the other group, that group, praise the Lord, they deserve mia, mia. And your group, they deserve one, 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 one. One, 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 one. Which one I'm talking about? Which one am I talking about? Praise the Lord.
Amina.
When I look in your group, don't lower yourself. God has blessed you. God has lifted you. And the moment God raises you, He raises you so that you can save life. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
There is a reason why God has elevated you. Don't lower yourself. My brother, my sister, if God has raised you, be a blessing. Be a blessing. Be a blessing. Be a blessing. Amen.
Amina.
Be a blessing. You can be somewhere. Praise the Lord. There is my friend somewhere. They were in a church. And then he came and told me,
akakuja akamwambia,
last Sunday,
Jumapili iliyopita,
we did a love offering.
Tulifanya
we did a love offering.
Tulifanya changisho.
And we raised
na tukatoa
7 plastic chairs.
Tukatoa viti 7 vya plastiki.
He's celebrating.
Anasherekea.
I looked at him.
Akamwangalia.
And I asked him.
Na akasema,
7 plastic chairs.
Viti 7 vya plastiki.
I asked him, did you just pledge once and
again.
He said we had a planning. We had a strategy to raise 7 plastic chairs. Then I asked, is that church flawed? The church is not flawed. And that church, you are a population of how many people? They said we are around 50. They said you are joking. That one I cannot celebrate.
Yes,
I cannot join you in that celebration. You are very many people. 50 people. 7 chairs. Planning for 6 months. I refuse that one. I say that no. That is no. It is not proportionate. It is not biblical. It is not in proportion to your status. Your status cannot allow you to give 7 plastic chairs or 500 shillings. 500 times 7, that is 3,500. Planning in 6 months, you are in that church. You are a 50 of you. You are a working people. People who are earning a salary. Part one is for one person. I refused. I refuse, my brother. You kitu nakata. Now to today, mimi nakata. How is kuletea ushuhuda wa aina, you know?
Amen.
Hiyo si ushuhuda. Hiyo sio ushuhuda, nataka kuambia kuna vitu singine wewe nakuwa sarakasi. Naona sio ushuhuda.
Amen.
Watu 50 kwa kanisa. Nataka kuelewana vizuri. Watu wangapi?
50.
Niliuliza wale wanafanya kazi, wakaniambia walikuwa 10. Watu ambao wanafanya kazi watu 10. Kwa watu 50. Viti ngapi? Viti
7.
Ya 500, 500. Hiyo ni pesa ngapi?
3,500.
3,000. 500. Are we supposed to dance? Are we supposed to dance? We cannot dance. Why is it? Because it is not proportionate. Our lifestyle and our status cannot allow us to dance with that one. I pray in Jesus' name. When God has raised you, be a blessing in the church. Be a blessing in the church. Be a blessing in the church. You are a bear. Even if you are a one person, people are giving 200. Rise up. Depending on your blessing. Depending on the way God has blessed you. Be a blessing. God will raise you in a particular place. He has raised you to be a blessing. To be a blessing. My brother, don't become proud. My sister, don't become proud. You are there for a purpose. You are in that church. You are in that place for a reason. Amen.
Amina.
Praise the name of the Lord. Sometimes wanachukua, if you put me in the committee, I am there. You are safe. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
You are safe. Because we shall ensure in that committee 100%. Amen. Amen. Because we are there.
Tuko pale.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We are there.
Tuko pale.
My brother, we are there.
Yangu, tuko
it
pale.
Cannot fail. There's somebody that was encouraged. He was discouraged. I tell that person, you will not be discouraged. As long as I'm here, as long as I'm here, you are sure of 100%. Because God has raised us for a purpose. I cannot be proud. I cannot boast. I cannot do anything. But I'm there. Not, I don't want to compare. I don't want to do things 200. Praise the Lord. This issue of 5,000 divided by 100. Each way you are keeping 500. And then it has failed. And you keep quiet. You are there. With your status. You are there. Watching people struggling. Watching people struggling. Praise the Lord. Mungu ametusaidia. Nakumbuka hii kanisa kuna mwaka. Tuli first tukiomba. Tukitaka microphone 2,500. Na hatu kupata. Haiku patikana. 2,500. Na microphone bado the same price now. Sinapatikana. Ama. Ukipata auja ya string. Even this wireless. Kuna sile 2,500. Wireless ones. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
But others are buying because of their level.
Kulingana viwango vyao.
Are there God can accept is your level. But when God has raised you,
kama Mungu amekuinua,
the way we are today, I pray in Jesus' name, may God open your eyes. May you get what I'm sharing today. It's supposed to be proportionate. Look at yourself. Look at your value. Praise the Lord. Look at your value. Are you cheap? Are you cheap? Are you cheap? You are not cheap. Amen. You know, I'm sharing this so that our minds can open. Not only, I'm not talking only to us. I'm talking to whoever is listening to me. But this is the way to go. It must be proportionate. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It must be proportionate. Amen.
Amen.
If I am no, I am an officer. Praise the Lord. You are an officer. If you are an officer,
yes.
You cannot take pound
kama
as an offering.
Wewe ni afisa, uwezi peleka shilingi 20 kama sadaka.
Amen. Mm. You are an officer.
Wewe ni afisa.
Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Kama tena ume, yanu unaelewa inasema. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
It is what? Proportionate.
Lazima iwiane.
That is why I was saying, for us to increase, divine increase will come for the people who are proportionate.
Amen.
You can be in a church where you are the only one working. You are the only one. Don't go with others. You are the only one. Come out strongly. When others are struggling with 50, with 100, come with 10. We are finished. There is somebody was telling me a good testimony. I felt good. There is a member, one member in that church. That member, I think when he dies, people will pray, but he resurrects. We know there are some members when they die, you pray that they resurrect. Why? Because whenever there is a problem,
like
remember he was telling that one day they didn't have a keyboard. Praise the Lord. They didn't have a keyboard in the church. So he came and asked. He told Pastor, let us go to Nairobi. Want to buy a keyboard. Praise the Lord.
Mm.
Then he went there. Which is the highest PSR SX in this series? 950 or 900? 950?
Yeah, 950.
Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Ours is 700.
Yeah,
so we still have us another series higher than this. So they go there, they say we want this highest series on PSR, SX. Want the highest.
Walitaka ya juu.
They will say, how much?
Pesa ngapi?
They say now, maybe 200,000. maybe 200,000.
Labda
you say, okay, sawa, we can take it.
Chukua.
Take that one.
Chukua hiyo.
One day, a generator broke down. A generator broke down.
Generator ikaharibika.
One day.
Siku moja.
So he said, we want to go and buy a generator.
Tulikuwa twende tununue.
Yes, pastor, which one?
Akauliza pastor, ipi?
We want Honda.
Tunataka Honda.
Let us go.
Akasema twende.
He bought that one.
Akanunua
hiyo. So it's one person who is a blessing in that church. I pray in Jesus' name. May God give you the spirit. May God raise you. May God give you resources so that you can be a blessing. Sometimes God has raised you. He has given you resources so that you can support the church. You can build the church. You can empower the church. You can add value. Even your community. You are not just raised to be there. I thank God for Joseph. Joseph told his brothers, God has brought him here in order to save lives. Sometimes God has put you there in order to save lives. It's not for your enjoyment. God has raised you. He has given you resources. He has given you money. So that you can support the work of God. You can support missions. You can support projects. May God open your eyes and empower you in Jesus' name. We declare right now, in the name of Jesus, every spirit of financial struggle, we come against it in Jesus' name. Financial struggle is not our portion. We refuse any kind of struggle in Jesus' name. May God give us resources in your life, give resources in your family so that you can empower. You can empower others. You can empower your people, empower your friends, empower people who come to your life. I pray, may God open your eyes, open your eyes, open your minds, open your everything in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the Lord. Are we understanding? Amen.
Yeah,
are you getting that?
Yeah,
when you get this, it will bring a blessing in your life,
kwa maisha yako,
in your family.
Kwa jamii yako.
Your family will be blessed.
Jamii yako
your children will be blessed. And everything will experience in the name of Jesus.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
And number four, which I think the last one for today,
kitu cha mwisho,
biblical giving
ile kutoa kwa kibiblia,
is consistent.
Inaendelea.
It's alone. So this man, he was talking to the church of Church of Corinth. I think they were doing something. Then they reached somewhere. They gave up. I think there was a project. I think they had pledged. And then they reached somewhere. They never finished their pledges. And that is why in verse 10 and verse 11 he said this.
Anasema hivi,
a year ago you started not only to do this work but also decide to do. Verse 11. So finish doing it as well.
Lakini sasa timizeni kule kutenda nako.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
They had been doing something and they stopped along the way.
Kule.
He told them, finish. The will of God is that you finish.
Umalize.
You must finish. Whatever you
pledge,
you must
lazima
finish.
Umalize.
Praise the Lord.
Amina.
It's the will of God that you finish whatever you had pledged, whatever you had promised, whatever you had decided to do. Biblical giving is consistent. It does not depend with your mood. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
It does not go with your mood. But today, I feel bored. I feel discouraged. Today I'm not giving. I'm not giving today. I feel not good. The message today, it didn't please me. This is not the right message. And therefore today, I'm giving 200. I had planned. When I left home, I'm giving 1,000. But when I leave the church, the message, it was about giving. And therefore, I have decided I am not giving. We cannot move with the mood. Amen. You cannot move the mood. Whether you quarreled with your husband, Whether you quarreled with your wife, you cannot come and change. But now I quarrel. I am decided. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Giving is biblical. It is consistent. It does not depend on your circumstances. It does not depend on your situation. The Berean church, the church of Thessalonica, the church of Philippi, poor as they were, they didn't have an excuse not to give. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. I remember when we began moving on with our project, I received a message. Pastor must stop.
Pastor, lazima
he must know that
lazima
people
ujue
are straining.
Watu
people are straining
watu
in this project.
Watu
people are straining.
Watu
and therefore,
na hivyo sasa,
pastor must
pastor
stop. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Who is straining?
Nani
show me five people.
Watu tano.
They are straining. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Show me five people.
Watu tano.
You know, people speak sometimes on behalf of others who have not even sent them. Watu wanaumia. Ni watu gani hesabu 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ambao wako wanaumia. And how much have they given to show that they are suffering?
Amen.
I pray in Jesus' name. Let our giving be consistent. Be consistent. In season. Out of season. It should not depend on external factors. We should not be forced. We should not be influenced by others. People should not influence you. What you have decided. What you have planned. You should not be influenced. No. Nobody should dictate. Praise the Lord.
Amina.
Understand this. Giving is part of worship. It is my duty. I have an obligation. We must show commitment in Jesus' name. Understand. Biblical giving is very important. When you understand, you will be blessed. God will bless you. Nobody will force you to do anything because you understand. Understand the Bible. But it's costly. It grows from time to time. It is also proportionate. It is consistent. Depending on the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 8 from verse 1 to 14. May the Lord bless you. May you grow in your resources. May you grow as a family. May you enjoy the favor of God. May enjoy the goodness of Lord as you purpose to obey God through biblical giving. In Jesus' name, I want us to pray. And I want us to make a prayer that God may help you so that you may practice the biblical giving. Apart from other things, may God help you to practice biblical giving. I want us to stand and make a statement. Just one or two words to God. I know this one. The Bible says the word of God came to us like unto them. But the word never benefited them because they never mixed the word of God with faith. In the name of Jesus, just tell God, may you God increase us in our giving. In Jesus' name, may God help us. May we increase in our giving today. In the name of Jesus. We declare today in Jesus' name, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I appreciate you. I give you honor. Thank you for speaking to us. Many times we have suffered. Even our families have suffered because of lack of understanding. I pray in Jesus' name that each one of us will understand biblical giving. But we'll be able to do it the way God will bless us, not on how we feel, on the circumstances that are surrounding us, not because of the other influence. Father, I pray that through our challenges, through our hardship, Jehovah, we are going to do it. We are going to obey your word and practice Jehovah. Father, in Jesus' name, I pray you are blessing us. Where we are, it's not the right right place. This is not our position. Father, it's your will for us to do better than where we are. Father, we pray. May you multiply even our lives. Multiplying the life of our children. Blessing them with the resources. Blessing them with a blessing from above, Jehovah. I pray, Jehovah,
that
no one of us will struggle in life because of resources. You bless us with a number of resources, with multiple resources, with all those. Father, we rebuke even the devourer, the destroyer of our resources, the destroyer of our lives. We come against every destroyer of our resources in Jesus' name. Destroyer of sickness, of diseases, accidents, ever and non-diseases. We come against them, destroying our resources. Father, we pray, diseases from the devil, we rebuke them in Jesus' name. Come out of our life and set us free. I pray for freedom. Freedom, freedom. Freedom, freedom. Every demonic attack, we come against them. Thank you, my Father, because you have blessed us. You have raised us again for the glory of your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate, 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 celebrate. Celebrate. Jesus, we give you praise. We celebrate. We celebrate your blessing. We celebrate your good thing. Amen.